वेलकम सुस्वागतम आयुभुवन ऊरागु आय सौरभ उपाय ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मराठवाडा मित्रमंडळ शंकरराव चव्हाण लॉ कॉलेज एज वेल एज ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ युनिव्हर्सिटी ऑफ कोलंबो श्रीलंका वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेलिब्रेशन दॅट वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग फर्स्ट ॲनिव्हर्सरी ऑफ आर इंटरनॅशनल कॉन्फरन्स विच वॉज हेल्ड ऑन 17th and 18th of January 2020. So today is the 16th of January 2021 and here we are going to celebrate our academic ties that we had from 2020. So this was just the first thing that we did, that was the international conference, and today we are going to have our book launch on the same topic, legal dimensions of human rights in the technological realm. During that conference, we had witnessed 172 participants from all over India, some from Sri Lanka, and some were from the other part of the world. We also had received 52 research papers, out of which 38 research papers that we had presented during our conference. And now we are coming up with this book of 22 chapters on legal dimensions of human rights in the technological realm. So now I request Indira ma'am to address the gathering. Over to Indira ma'am.
Thank you very much. Good morning. And I Bowen, Dr. Kranti Deshmukh, the principal, Marthavada Mitra Mandal's Shankaravo Chavan Law College, Pune, India. Professor Vasanta Seniviratna, Head of Department of Public and International Law, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, and the Director CSHR, Assistant Professor Saurabh Ubale, my colleagues at both Shankarao Chavan Law College and the Faculty of Law, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed my pleasure and privilege to address this important occasion, the anniversary celebration of the international conference jointly organized by the Shankarao Chavan Law College, Pune, India, and the Center of Study of Human Rights, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka. This conference was held on 17th and 18th January 2022 in Pune, India, in order to strengthen the ties of both our renowned institutions. And most importantly, the unveiling ceremony of the edited book under the theme, Legal Dimension of Human Rights in the Technological Realm, published jointly by Shankarao Law College, Pune, India, and the CSHR Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka. This publication contains a collection of research articles the researchers presented at the said international conference. One of the most important functions of teachers of higher educational institution is to engage in research with a view to exposing hitherto uncharted territories in their chosen disciplines. This drives research to produce and disseminate new knowledge to wider communities. I take great joy in noting that our two esteemed institutes strive to maintain high standards of research by inquiring into topics of contemporary significance, of which this publication now brings to you. I hope that this publication would prove useful to scholars, researchers, practitioners, and the large legal community as a valuable source of legal thinking and reference. This creates a positive environment for continuing the research tradition of our two institutes. I warmly congratulate the editors, Professor Vasanta Seniviratna and Assistant Professor Ubale, all the authors for their effort, and hope this and future research outputs of our two institutions would lead to enhancing the human potential and the lives of the people of our nations. Last year, with my colleagues of the Faculty of Law, we participated at the International Conference in Pune, India on the invitation extended to us by the Shankarrao Chavan Law College. I would wish to take this opportunity to express my deep gratitude and appreciation to the principal, the staff, and the students for extending this invitation to the academic staff members of the faculty to participate at the international conference. We greatly appreciate your warm hospitality and the diligent work, meticulous arrangement that had been made to organize the conference. This collaboration gives us an opportunity to create cooperation and connectivity between the two institutions. Each of us is endowed with abundant skills, resources, and opportunities. We can prosper and grow together and can make an important contribution to the legal education and improve the profession in ways that none can accomplish alone. We can share many opportunities for the development of teaching and research program. We can enter into various collaborative arrangements. We can create interaction among scholars and students. In order to do that, we must join hands, break barriers, build friendship and human solidarity. Because I'm certain that we all have one common vision, that is providing and maintaining quality legal education. I wish to congratulate all of you for your untiring efforts in organizing today's event. It is my sincere wish that this collaboration will result in heighten our cooperation that will enable both our institutes to rise to meet both its challenges, current and future. I wish you a great success. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, Indira ma'am. We still remember that we had a great discussion during our conference as well. After hearing you from so many months, I wish to share some of the the glimpses of the international conference that we had taken it from the some of the photographs that we had during our conference. Just have a look over the memories that we had during this particular conference. We are graced with our two of the vice chancellors from the National Law University, along with the head of the Department of Law, SPPU, and our colleagues from Sri Lanka and India, both of the institutes. We had a great help from all these of the faculties of the Columbia University. And we had a great discussion. We also had witnessed a valedictory function, which was graced by one of the High Court judge in India. So these are not just the memories, but we can say this, that these are the hopes to have more collaboration, more social aspects to be covered, because unless we had great research, then only we can have the great responsibilities to be done and to be given to the society. So something that we can give to the society through these activities as well. Okay, thank you so much, Indira ma'am. Now, without further delay, I hand over this to our beloved principal ma'am, Kranti ma'am, who is a guiding beacon behind all the success that we usually brought together to these institutions. So over to you, Kranti ma'am.
Thank you so much, Saurabh sir. Professor Mrs. Indira madam, Professor and Dean, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka. Vasanta Madam, Professor, Faculty of Law and Director, Center for the Study of Human Rights, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka. My other colleagues from Sri Lanka and from Shankara Chavan Law College. I heartily welcome all of you in today's anniversary celebration of this international conference. I still remember last year we could meet and we were actually enjoying engross in different sessions on the topic, and it was really very joyful experience. I extend my gratitude to Indira Madam and Vasanta Madam for accepting our invitation and for coming to India to attend this international conference. As Indira Madam rightly mentioned that this activity or this collaboration, we are looking forward for the development in legal research and in legal area, in development of legal research in the legal fraternity. So I'm very hopeful that from Shankara Chavan Law College and from University of Colombo, togetherly we can contribute for the development of this legal research. The publication which we are going to do today, it is a tremendous hard work of both the editors, Saurabh Ubare sir and Vasanta Madam. And it is really a nice work. I think this publication will definitely get so much appreciation when we will actually send it out to the people. There are lots of hopes from this publication. And really, the contributions and research which we have done through this publication is very good. It has got potential. And definitely, we will be sending the copies of this publication to Sri Lanka also, and to all the dignitaries, guests, and participants of the international conference. And we will make this publication available in different parts so that it will get wide range of publicity. So I'm thankful to Vasanta Madam and Saurabh Ubare sir for this joint collaboration and for the publication. As Madam said in the beginning, that publication and international conference is just one step. But in future also, we are looking forward for many activities which we can conduct jointly. Definitely, we were expecting one event in 2021 or 2020. But because of this COVID situation, we could not do anything. But definitely, if everything gets normalized, then next year, I wish that we could actually see each other, we could actually meet each other, and we can exchange the knowledge, and we can conduct more activities in physical manner, not online. But still, I'm happy that during such difficult time also, we could meet online. That connection is important, keeping in touch is important than other thing. And I'm very, what we can say, consider myself fortunate, or we should consider ourselves fortunate, that our international conference was the last event last year which we could conduct physically. And after that, immediately the world has stopped and everything got stopped. So fortunately, we could complete it. We could attend the conference, and it was a great success. In India also, we got very good response in international conference, and they really appreciated efforts which were taken by the University of Colombo and by Shankara Chavan Law College. So once again, I welcome you all. It is really pleasure meeting you all. And now I hand over mic to Saurabh sir. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to express my thoughts. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. You have always been inspiration to all of us to have such kind of collaborative activities, huge research, and a lot of social work through our academics. Thank you so much, ma'am. Now again, without further delay, I hand over the mic to Vasanta ma'am, the editor of this book. So, over to you, Vasanta ma'am.
Thank you very much. Dr. Kranti Deshamukh, Principal Shankarao Chavan Law College, Professor Indira Nanayakara, Dean of the Faculty of Law, Sri Lanka, who are the conveners of the joint international conference between the Center for the Study of Human Rights, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka, and Marthavada Mitra Mandal Shankarao Chavan Law College, Pune. Associate Professor Saurabh Ubale, Dr. Ashwini Ngole, and the academic staff of both the law teaching institutions, authors of the volume one of the book titled Legal Dimensions of Human Rights in the Technological Realm. Ladies and gentlemen, I am privileged and honored to attend this launching ceremony and the grand celebration of the joint conference that we had in 2020, exactly a year ago. We still, as Madam Indira Nanayakara, as well as Madam Kanti recall, that we are very grateful and we cherish the fond memories of the conference and the hospitality and friendship extended to us during our stay in Pune. And the rich contribution of knowledge into the legal arena brought from an array of perspectives by the researchers who presented at the conference and now have authored in the present volume. What we could witness at the conference was the dedication by all the researchers to engage in dynamic research to find the interrelatedness between human rights and technology with the purpose of serving the humankind to achieve human dignity in a better way in the 21st century and ahead. The outcome of the research has been overwhelming and eye-opening. The publication of the volume one that included the first set of research papers presented at the conference are truly outstanding. We believe that this is one of the greatest services of a law school in terms of disseminating the knowledge amongst the wider readership and other stakeholders in our societies. We are looking forward to produce the second volume two in the near future without delay. We are deeply indebted to the executive president of the Marathwada Mitra Mandal, as well as principal Dr. Kranti Deshamukh of the Shankrao Chavan Law College, Dr. Ashwini Ingole, associate professor Saurabh Ubale, without whom I don't think that we can done this launch so soon, who has been in constant contact with me, always with his very nice and cheerful smile. And also Ms. Mayura Sabne, all who contributed to this great endeavor and others who contributed to make this event such a success. I wish all the very best to all the authors who have added their rich legal literature to this book. Let me express our heartfelt gratitude to all of you for pioneering this event and endeavor to come this far along the joint road. We are looking forward to strengthen our mutual bond and more collaborations between the two institutions in the days and years to come. Thank you and wish you all the very best, safety and blessings wholeheartedly. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for being with me for during the whole thing that we did with this edited book and the whole conference that we did. Tremendous successful success that we got during our academic ties. Thank you so much, ma'am. Now I'll.
Thank you. Actually, you deserve the most portion of it. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, ma'am. Now I'll just declare that the book to be launched. Now I'll just show you by sharing the screen, the title page and the first few pages of this edited book, during which the author's also going to get the email within next 3 to 5 minutes, getting their e-copies of the edited book. So once we get it, the hard copies published, then we're going to send the hard copies to all the authors. So here is the first view of our edited book. So this is the edited book, Legal Dimensions of the Human Rights in the Technological Dream, that we come up with. It is, as it is stated, that it has been jointly published by the Center for the Study of the Human Rights, CSHR, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka, and Marathwada Mitra Mandal, Shankrao Chavan Law College, Pune. Is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University and accredited with A grade by NAC India. So we had included the convener's message been conveyed by Professor Mrs. Indira Madam and Dr. Kranti Deshmukh Madam. It has been acknowledged that we are deeply indebted to all the vice chancellors, principals of different colleges, all the faculties of both of the institutions, and some of the students who have helped us in having this particular launch of this book and making this edited book. So here are the name of the authors that we wish to thanks to them. Deepa Paturkar Madam, we have Ziasa Madam, We have Nuwani Nirmani, madam. We have Kamlakar Vadmare, sir. We have Tejupsini, madam. We have P. Velraj, sir, from Chennai High Court. We have Payal Thavre, madam, from Nagpur. We have Vikas Bhatnagar, sir, and Pradeep Kumar Tambe, sir, from Marathwada Mitra Mandal Shankara Saman Law College. We have Priyanka Zawale, madam. We have Ashwini Biradar, madam, and Rucha Shinde, madam. We have Isha Saxena, Unmesha Patil, Divya Mittal, madam, Pratik Salgar, sir, Rishikesh Honkala, sir. We have Abdul Rahman, sir. We have Pawar Kalyani and Ms. Mulla Fatima, Ms. Mugdha Sapute, Ms. Anushita Dube, and Ms. Aditi Kagore. And the last chapter we have is with Ms. Avantika Shukla. So thank you everyone for presenting the paper and making this edited book possible so that we can have this particular publication of this edited book. So thanks everyone for contributing to this particular research. And again, as said by the Indira ma'am and also by Kranti ma'am and Vasanta ma'am, that this is just the start of the research collaboration, and we still need to have more focus on the research part so that we can have overall social development at each and every perspective. So within next 2 minutes, all the authors will receive the copies of this particular e-copy of this particular book. Now I request Hakim sir to tell us about their experience in India with this particular collaboration. Over to Hakim sir.
Thank you Professor Indira Nanikara and Dr. Kranti and Professor Vasanta Saniratna. And Saurabh is my old friend. Now you became very old friend now. Yeah, I'm very happy to address because I'm in the middle of exam supervision today. So it has been 1 year. I can't believe this is has gone 1 year. Still, we have very pleasant memory of excellent, admiring Indian hospitality. That's number one. Number two, we shared the latest knowledge on technology, as well as the first time we stepped in Pune. That was very pleasant time in Pune. And also we wanted to continue this collaboration in the future as well, Dr. Kranti and Madam Indira Nanekara pointed out. We are hoping to have more and more activities. There are a number of other research collaboration and exchange programs, and we are going to have an online lecture series now. And also we will think about this collaborative moot court competition now. So that's another area of concern. We are thinking of that. So we hope to have more collaboration, and also we wanted to have continued publication of this particular journal. And also we are very hope that was our last trip to overseas. All our Sri Lankan counterpart, that was a very last trip to overseas. Thereafter it was became lockdown everywhere and we couldn't move anywhere. We had the last trip, very pleasant memories with us. Actually, I can't believe this is all 1 year gone, right? So we are very happy and we want to see you all again physically. So, and also it's your turn, Saurabh and Dr. Kranti, madam. It's your turn, you'll have to come to Sri Lanka and you have to enjoy our bountiful and beautiful Sri Lanka. And you can enjoy our Sri Lankan hospitality as well. So with this note, I thank you for organizing this and so wish you all the best, all the authors of this publication, and we are hoping to contribute in the future too. Thank you. Thank you, Saurabh, for this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your kind words. Remembering that we were met in the Hague Academy, and no, this is just not the first meeting that we had, but this is kind of a relation that we have maintained. Thank you so much for being always my inspiration and being with me as my brother all the time. Thank you so much, Hakim sir. Now I request Dr. Ashwini Ingole, madam, to say some few words as she was the program coordinator of this international conference. Over to you, Ashwini, ma'am.
think she is mute.
Madam, your mic is mute. Ashwini, madam, your mic is mute.
Yes, good morning to all. And yes, Indira ma'am, Vasanta ma'am, then Hakim sir, all we miss you a lot. Okay, so thank you, Saurabh, for giving me an opportunity to express my view. So it is always well said that the journey matters and not the destination. The journey we started with the idea of holding international conference in collaboration with Sri Lankan University is being culminated in the today's event of book publication. Down the line of 1 year, this journey seems more memorable than its destination, which it has achieved today. We started this journey with numerous preparation and minute details discussed with our Sri Lankan partners and successfully hosted the conference in our campus premises. Today, we feel truly honored with the collaboration with our Sri Lankan colleagues who cooperated wholeheartedly in our joint endeavor. Today, when I look back, I feel enchanted by memorizing that we could extend our warm hospitality to our Sri Lankan guests. I feel satisfied by memorizing that our Sri Lankan guests could enjoy all the delicacies of Pune and were able to take away with them lovely cherished memories of their visit to Pune. This collaboration has given me immense experience and soulful memories, which are one of the best memories of my academic career. Every moment spent in this journey is a piece of beautiful mosaic which will be cherished by both of us for times to come. Thank you for this opportunity and kind support, and we look forward to have such a journey together in future as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for being a pillar in organizing this particular conference and being everywhere in all the difficulties that we have faced during this particular organizing successfully this conference. Now I request Minaka sir to say a few words.
I think he has some connection problems, and Dr. Udapadi is here.
Okay. So we'll move to Udapadi ma'am.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, ma'am. Before you start, we are also missing Mithya as well.
Mithya, yes. She's around. Okay. Very good
very
morning to you all.
Of our conference.
Thank you. Actually, it's a great pleasure to see you all just after a year. When the International Conference on Legal Dimension of Human Rights in the Technological Realm was held on 17th and 18th January 2020 in Pune, India. It is also great to see that the output of the conference is made to a written form of publication within a year. We also hope to contribute to the second volume of it in the near future. We regret that we were unable to make it given the scenario. All for all, the close tie which has been developed between us as the premium institutes in the legal academia in India and Sri Lanka is noted respectfully. Also, I make this opportunity to thank you all, the head of the Law College, Dr. Kranti, Professor Saurabh, Dr. Ashwini, in particular, all the student representatives, right, and all the members of the staff for their great hospitality offered to us. Actually, thank you so much. I don't take lengthy of time to talk more. Actually, I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Udapadi ma'am. So we hope we'll see now physically either in Sri Lanka or in India soon again to take this research ties ahead. Now, as we have a little bit of time, now we'll move to vote of thanks. I request Mayura Sabne Madam, who was also there as an important pillar in organizing this international conference. So I request Mayura Ma'am to go ahead with vote of thanks.
Thank you, Saurabh sir. Good afternoon, everyone. I, Assistant Professor Mayura Sabne from Shankar Rao Chavan Law College, Pune, propose vote of thanks on behalf of all of us. We are deeply indebted to Professor Chandrika Madam, Vice Chancellor of the University of Colombo, and Principal Mr. B.G. Jadhav sir, Executive President Marathwada Mitra Mandal, for their constant support, expertise, knowledge, and encouragement, which has been the very great force behind the successful accomplishment of this joint endeavor. I express my special thanks to Professor Mrs. Indira Madam, Professor and Dean, Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka, Mr. S. D. Gange, sir, President, and Mr. Kushar Mungle, sir, Secretary, Marathwada Mitra Mandal, Dr. Kranti Deshmukh, ma'am, our beloved principal, Marathwada Mitra Mandal, Shankar Rao Chavan Law College, Pune, and Mr. Hakim, sir, Deputy Director, Center for the Study of Human Rights, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka, for their useful insights and cooperation. I wish to offer my sincere gratitude to Vasantha Madam, Menaka sir, Sampath sir, Darshana sir, Madhushanka sir, Udapadi Madam, Isankhya Madam, and Thalini Madam from the Faculty of Law, University of Colombo, for their wonderful memories. I am also grateful to Dr. Ashwini Ingole and Assistant Professor Saurabh Bubale, without whose support this whole conference and this whole journey would not have been successful. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Pratap Salunke, Dr. Pradeep Kumar Tambe, Dr. Vikas Bhatnagar, Mrs. Revati Naik, Dr. Bhagwan Gauri, Mr. Gajendra Dhamma sir, Mr. Krishna Badade ma'am, faculties at Marathwada Mitra Mandal Shankar Rao Chavan Law College Pune for their kind cooperation throughout this journey. We are also truly blessed to have wonderful team of young students from Shankar Rao Chavan Law College who helped us during this work of editing and publishing the book. Mr. Sahil Srivastav, Mr. Mugdha Satpute, Mr. Praful Tonge, Ms. Aditi Kalbor, Ms. Rucha Kulkarni, Ms. Anushita Dubey, Mr. Yash Sahu, Mr. Ashutosh Patare, and Ms. Amruta Borge. I thank all of them